Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the athletes and officials for the bronze medal match for the men's individual foil.
Well, a big round of applause for defenders as they march out to fight for the bronze medal. The hardest of matches to compete in. They have to pick themselves up from the disappointment of going out in the semi-finals, and now it's time to get back out. Choi of Korea has had just about 15 minutes to recover from his defeat. Baldini, well, he's had a longer time to think about what he has to do to come away from these Olympics with a medal. He's previous world champion, but never stood on a podium at the Olympic Games.
Introducing the fencers for the bronze medal match. From the Republic of Korea, Choi Byungchul!
Choi, unorthodox to say the least, and Karim Bashir. Do you think that Baldini would have watched any of that Choi versus Abu Al Qasim match?
I'm sure he was watching it. I'm sure he and his coach will have a very clear idea of what they're going to do and how they're going to do it. And I'm more than convinced that Andrea Baldini will
your video referee, Douglas Finlay.
Fairly unpredictable Choi that Baldini has to deal with. But Baldini has the speed and the technical ability.
Athletes, please salute your opponent.
Nick Payne assisting the referee, a more British interest, and it's certain that the officiating of the British delegation has certainly improved as a result of this Olympic Games.
Referee, so, masks on, and it's time for the bronze medal bout. Choi on the left. Baldini of Italy on the right. Skillful, technically perfect Italian against the maverick, fairly unpredictable Choi.
First. And so far, the maverick is playing a classical role.
Angar, pre, ale.
This looks a little bit more like what we're used to.
Alt, attack, pare, riposte, normala.
Well, he wouldn't have got this far if he couldn't actually fence. Angar. That's the thing. You know, he is in the playoff for an Olympic bronze medal, and he has pulled some incredible manoeuvres and had a few red cards given against him.
I think he may have got a little bit up into the throat there. Not deliberate, but Baldini did immediately acknowledge there'd been a clash.
Angat.
Look at this.
Mr. Choi, masks, please.
Just the guard clipping the bottom of the mask. And completely by accident, Baldini immediately puts his hand up. He's fine, though.
And of the three Italian fencers that we've seen tonight, Baldini has been probably the least cocky, the least showboating on the piece. He's strutting around. He's just gone about his business, and he's got about it very well.
And some might say controversial selection of the Italian team with Giorgio Avola higher ranked.
Pre, ale.
I think I think that Baldini's experience running over from Evola. Evola is the reserve for the team event, of course. But it's pretty tough for the Italians. Evola is ranked too much higher than I think he's testing to see if the area of the target is the off target area is registering on the target.
Well, he thought he was hit down around the right buttock, which was in the off target area.
Yeah, so he was testing to see where that came up.
In the behind, should we say?
Yeah, I think we should say that. But clearly not. If you can't replicate the error, then it's not going to wash with the referee.
Alt, attack, non valable.
Baldini scurried away from that attack from Choi.
It's a bit controversial decision because Cassara ranked first in the world, Aspromonte second, Evola third, and he wasn't selected for the individual. Instead, Andrea Baldini ranked 14th in the world. But Baldini's done more than justify his position in this team.
Would that have been a tactical decision based on world ranking? But they wouldn't have known how they were going to end up in the draw because it's all randomised anyway.
Well, they ranked first in the world, in fact, in the team event. Randomised, so there would be no necessary benefit. I think it would just be that the coach has decided. There is the coach.
Video per la mano.
Payne, who is the assistant referee, has not raised his arm. And now they go to the video over this. Stefano Cerioni, a men's foil fencer of some note. Look, you're not going to be able to see it from that angle because. Okay, if Baldini's blade was anywhere near it, then perhaps you'd give that. And apparently it was. So the card has been given. Troy points to the assistant referee to say, well, he didn't play. But nonetheless, he's got a yellow card now. Infringements, and his opponent will score a hit.
This seems to be part of his game. It's probably not a good
part.
He has, in both of the fights that we've seen him, he has incurred at least one red card. Two in the last fight.
Attack.
Baldini's.
Baldini's attack there.
Angal.
Choi trying to arch his back to avoid the tip. Unsuccessfully on that time.
Alt, attack.
Interaction.
No. Are. Touché. Angal. Monsieur Baldini, masque, s'il vous plaît. Angal.
More orthodox fashion in this fight than I have done in the last two.
Well, maybe he's done his homework on Baldini and he knows that.
Alt, attack off there.
Say that touché. Pure speed alone won't help him, but on that occasion,
Angal.
Speed did help him. Baldini wasn't quick enough to get away. And some of those running attacks that we saw in the semi-final.
Well, there's going to be another card here.
One video.
This time it's red and Payne did put his hand up, the assistant referee. He's standing at Baldini's end, which means that he's looking for infringements from Choi. And he needs to remain impassive because obviously the Korean fencer will try and not intimidate, but try and influence what's going on.
Так паре репош туш по паде коварти ангат сон мон ангат но но видео ангат
red card talking away
месхе ла маск ангат ту ле де ла маск се ла дерньер фуа ту ле де ла маск пре але Al lare, no malade. Angat. Pre. Ale. Al l'attack pare. Ripostus.
Qua. Choi.
Ammira di più.
Angat. Angat, s'il vous plaît.
Classic.
Delaying
tactics.
Ale.
Great footwork from Baldini. Choi's footwork is fast and furious. Yeah, absolutely. It's not perhaps learned in the manual. Well, actually, his own guard position is very good. But it's the rhythm and the pace and the pattern of his footwork was just phenomenal to see. The speed at which he changed direction and the speed at which he or the explosion of his acceleration is unbelievable. And Baldini now is complaining about something.
Technique.
The referee looks back to
Baldini.
Back to the video. I'm not sure what is going on here. There's a white light on the electric jacket of Choi, which means there's a dead spot. Now that's not Choi's fault because that jacket has been through the weapons control, so it's passed. It's past the weapons control. Choi will now need to change that jacket, but Baldini knows exactly where he hit, and he was able to replicate the fault. He won't get this hit now. The video won't be conclusive enough for them to award that hit.
Some more drama involving a Korean athlete.
It's more than possible for that jacket to have failed during the day. So it's passed the temperature. And during the day, it's dropped some water, and some sweat got onto it.
Why is Choi
being checked and replaced by the technicians and the action will?
Why is Choi taking everything off? Does he need to take his
4-3?
The other reason that we might be in the dead spot here.
Choi.
Oh yes, I mean clearly on the target that one. In fact, so clear that if the rules allowed it, I'd suggest giving that to Baldini, but they don't, unfortunately. He's taking everything off because. It's a strange one, but sometimes that's actually the wireless t-shirt that they have to wear. It helps.
Si devi far sentire l'accelerazione, se non la senti. Si parte una volta di chiudere.
The wireless t-shirt got so sweaty that it's failed. I remember fencing once in Malaysia, in Kuala Lumpur. And it was ridiculously hot and ridiculously humid. So much so that the moisture in your breeches and your jacket were creating a connection between what wasn't the llama jacket and the normal jacket, or your llama jacket and the normal jacket, so you could hit halfway down the arm. Which is normally
off to carry it through onto the jacket and record a hit.
Exactly. And it was most fencers carry at least one spare set of kit. So these guys would probably carry two or three spare kit sets of kit. And changing kit is not an unusual thing to do even midway through a competition. Let's see the wireless t-shirt, the blue wireless t-shirt there. You'll have to wear. He's going to put the same Lamo jacket on. And they'll make him change that one as well. Now the armourer has come out and he's actually laying it down and testing. So another twist in the fencing tale. Baldini knows this isn't Choi's fault. Baldini knows this is a technical issue.
He's having a good old test though, isn't he?
Hang on.
Well, quite right too, isn't it?
Tule de la mask.
Troy puts his hand up to Baldini.
So ladies and gentlemen, if we could settle down then, the athletes are ready to recommence.
Your kid's tested the same as mine.
Score stands at 4-3.
Hang on.
In the meantime, having said that Baldini was going to win this easily,
Ale.
He's 4-3, 1 point down in this first period.
Al, attack, no, contra-attack, touch, point.
Early days yet.
Angard, pre, ale. Al, stop, l'attack, touch, point.
Rhythm again. It's unexpected, it's Angard. Unusual. To go backwards like this, and then suddenly before your front foot's even landed on the ground going back, you're already launching yourself forward. Very clever.
Attacco per touché, qua, tule de la.
Immediately calls for video repost, and it was a counter repost rather than a parallel repost. It was his turn, not Choi's.
See if we see this on the slow motion replay.
Tule de alafer, l'attaque offer, touché, quoi.
It's gone.
Angar. Angar.
As the referee said, and it's gone to Choi. So
la masque. C'est la dernière fois, la masque.
Baldini has used up the video appeal,
Ale.
Unsuccessful.
Ale.
He's now 4 points down.
Al, attack, touché, point.
And now Choi saying he hit him on the leg.
S'il vous plaît, monsieur. La masque. Angard. Angard. Êtes-vous prêt? Allez.
7-4. fast as well. Two of them. Very quick with their feet. Baldini's starting to restore order. But that one's choice.
That's
a strange one. I'm not sure how to call this. He does start slightly before the first referee.
Ale. Alt. Post. Pass. S'il vous plaît, Monsieur Maldini.
Big shouts of encouragement from the Italian contingent in the crowd.
Attack
fails.
Are
attack finishing with a lunge.
Yeah, he's, it's funny, Choi started off fighting classically and was able to match Baldini point for point. And it's Baldini that's almost decided to fight the way that Choi would want him to.
First period out. Yeah, and I was waiting for this period to say that my feeling is that Baldini and his coach Choi have prepared for the Choi we've seen.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we move into the final phase then
saved up his
of this
classic fencing,
bronze medal playoff.
His classic style fencing.
Champion Choi
for the final. Leads and Baldini wasn't prepared for it.
Interesting
time in. They got their strategy wrong. Is my gut
Baldini has got 3 minutes now. To
belittle
try and
recover
his position in this fight and to move on to a bronze medal. But certainly looks sad that Choi is going to move on and take the bronze. Unless Baldini can pull something out of the hat. How do you feel, James?
Well, it's the Olympic Games. These athletes have got 3 minutes of work to make history and I'm not going
to
call it. Good luck to
both athletes.
I still think Baldini has a good chance of working his way back into this if he can just fight the fight that he is best at and not get too distracted.
Hang on.
Well, it's bluff, counter bluff.
Ali.
Who knows what we're going to see now? Wow, beauty. That's a fine right of way with Choi, who blocked out, but it wasn't quick enough. There's the block.
It
wasn't quick enough to get the remise of the riposte in there. So, 9-6.
Alt, attack offer. Touché. Point.
Well, this is how he started, isn't it?
Angad.
Same kind of fencing style.
Pre. Ali. Alt. Reprise attack. No malam.
Previous fight. His feet were so much close together.
Angad.
Pre.
Ali. Alt. Attack. Just push it.
Ready?
One.
Steady. Go. And off he goes.
And change. Gives Andrea Baldini just a little bit of thinking time.
En garde, monsieur.
Getting called en garde.
S'il vous plaît, la masque, en garde.
Very carefully. Doesn't get a yellow card for taking too long about it. So the Italians will consider this nothing less than a total disaster if they don't come away from the men's foil competition with without a single medal.
Nearly.
Can I say that was a deliberate loss of balance?
Monsieur. Pre.
Baldini steps in to draw the attack. The attack doesn't come. He doesn't even jump in the air because he's trying to go for a circle parry. Watch this. He's expecting an attack to come through. Choi doesn't attack, so Baldini on his landing just goes for it.
Ali.
Again, there was nothing there for Baldini to parry, and now the referee's assistant has put his hand up for covering the target. It's difficult to see from this angle because it's the back arm that we can see now. Its owner is the guilty party. We actually need to see the back hand. So
another
single light for Choi doesn't count because he can't score a hit and get a warning. The warning takes priority, and so it's now 11-8, even though there was a single red light.
Attack. No balad. Merci. En garde.
Baldini puts his hand up and says, I'll walk past before I hit that.
Alt. Attack. No balad.
So Baldini is back in touch.
Alec. Alt, attack the ghost, no malam. Angard. Pre.
Two more uncontested hits, and you think this game would be wide open. He's a wily old fox, is Andrea Baldini.
Alt, déplacement, pas de touche.
Choi is no...
En garde.
Mug.
Prêt. Êtes-vous prêt? Allez. Alt, touche,
point. En garde. Baldini is too close.
Merci Baldini. La masque. En garde.
Starting to look. Prêt.
Allez.
I like it's going to go the way.
Allez. Alt.
Of Byungchul Choi.
En garde. Prêt. Allez.
Oh, that's
Alt.
Good.
Reprise d'attaque. Push.
Sustained pressure from Baldini. First attack fail.
Angad.
Choi did nothing, so Baldini went for it again.
Tre. Ale. Alt. L'attaque offert, non. L'arrêt, non valable. Angad. Êtes-vous prêt? Allez.
Oh. Choi so fast scurrying back there.
Attack fails. Count is good.
Allez. Touche.
Baldini took his time coming in, took his time, picked his moment, it didn't work.
En garde. S'il vous plaît, Monsieur Baldini. Êtes-vous prêt?
A minute left in the second period. That's an attack from Baldini.
Merci,
Choi acknowledges that. This is still close enough that you can't really call it.
En garde.
But you'd rather be in Choi's position than you would be Baldini's.
I think if you were a betting man and you could in play on the fencing, then
Alt
would be on
Choi
right now. We have seen some incredible turnarounds.
Ale.
the business end. Pressure comes up.
And before that last action that we saw,
which causes Choi to try and defend something that isn't there.
Yeah, and Choi then feels he has right of way as he steps in. That's the real moment that Baldini's going for it, and he blocks out and scores. Again. You know, that's twice in the last few hits. But Baldini just hasn't been ready. It's just stuck.
It does seem to me that that is Choi's ace card. When he was down in the semi-final, he pulled out these amazing running attacks that he scored a lot of points from. And it's now got him to within 1 point of a bronze medal.
That's a big attack for Baldini, though. Well, the thing is that you would say to any youngster, you know, it's not ready, steady, go. You have to work for each hit. This guy has he's pulled out a couple of jokers, and he has gone straight from the B of the bag. Sabre, that's still the attacker's target for Choi. He found the blade. There's nothing doing there for
white light came on, so no points for Choi. It was his attack, so his right of way. So even though the coloured light came on, it made no difference to Baldini. So careful of Choi's amazingly fast attacks.
So, a parry riposte from Choi fails. There's the parry. The first action is no, and Baldini scores with a continuation.
About 17 seconds left on the clock of this second period.
There's a 14 all bronze medal match on now.
Baldini has worked his magic, he's used all of his experience. 8 seconds left. I would be very careful if I was Baldini of Choi's lightning attack.
Out time. No. So we get a minute. It's it's a bit like a soap opera. We come to a massive crescendo, and now we have an advert.
Well, now we have a chance to talk through exactly what happened in that second period.
We started at 9-5 down for Baldini. And in fact, it went 9-6, 10-6, 11-6, 11-7. And slowly but surely, Baldini was creeping back, scoring more often. And I just hope both defenses have got yellow cards. There, using the sword arm to deflect the opponent's blade. And he lights the guard around the piece, just looking magnificent. He's just outscoring Choi Baldini. And that's what's brought him to 14-all.
Destiny awaits.
13-9 down, he looked dead and buried though.
He certainly did, but he just used the experience to know he was not out of it. Well, there's 3 minutes on the clock that we will not need, because the next point scored will take the bronze medal. Choi has this lightning attack. He's not going to use it. Fencing now. Is Choi playing into Baldini's hands here?
Come on, still sharp on his feet, Mr. Payne.
Angad.
Has a bit of fencing himself.
Angad, s'il vous plaît.
Listen to the crowd, listen to the rumble of applause. Andrea Baldini has a section of supporters just in front of us with t-shirts.
Monsieur Choi, la distance, s'il vous plaît. Merci.
Plastered across the front of them.
What's the referee going to give here? He's compelled to go to the video.
What's your gut instinct?
Is he just so fast? Well, I don't know whether they were calling it, but I'll tell you what, the Italians didn't scream. Sometimes that's telling. Sometimes that's telling.
Very small screen in front of us down there. And in fact, on the side, we can see.
Does look like Baldini brings his arm back here. Let's see what the referee says.
L'attaque de gauche.
Good. Choi has just won.
So it's Choi that does it. Baldini wasn't convincing in the end. And Choi pulled out his classic fencing to beat the superior Italian, the Italian that had all of the experience. I don't think he's ever fenced anyone quite like Byungchul Choi.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
so it is Choi that wins the bronze medal. And that makes up for the massive Korean disappointment. A little bit of the Korean disappointment last night from the women's epee. And this is going to go down like a lead balloon in Italy.
It sure is. You've got to give it to Baldini, the third man on the team, has got the best result.
But
there will be question marks over Aspinotti and Cassara's exit from the competition early on. But hats off to this young Korean, 30-year-old Korean. Yeah, he's landed that hit way before Baldini gets in there.
Right, he started that hit so much earlier than he's
gold medal clearly coming right up. So do stay in your seats. We've got Lei Xiong of China. Can we have a cheer for China, please?
Baldini takes his mask off. And let's see the reaction on his face.
And also a cheer for Abu El Kassem of Egypt.
He knows that he's been hit.
Enjoy.
These super slimos are unbelievable. Fantastic.
Look at the expression on his face. He's pretty sure he got it there, didn't he?
It had to go to the
video replay because Baldini still had one. But if in all effect, it wasn't really needed. I think Baldini knew.
Well, this was one in the first period, a tactical play in the first period to come out and fence in a completely different way to the way that he'd fenced all day. He's not only brave, but it also proved to those of us, including myself, this is just an incredibly unorthodox approach to fencing. And then he goes and shows you that he can do it inverted commas, the European way, and do it better than one of the world's best in Andrea Baldini.
So, confirmation of the result. Byungchul Choi takes the bronze medal, 15-14, in a stunning end to that bout.